och välkomna till Miss Kitchen. Idag ska jag laga ett mellanmål eller tilltugg i köket. So let's go and have a look. So yeah, today I've thought of making something easy and mildly spicy for snacks. And of course, I love trying out Cornish pasties. People do make pasties with different types of fillings like beef, chicken, fish, etc. And the other day I had some couple of tuna cans around and frozen peas and corn. Separately that sound little boring, but when you add up together, you can come up with an amazing filling. So, ta-da! I've made tuna Cornish pasties at Miss Kitchen. So let's go and check the ingredients.
For the filling, 1 chopped small onion, 3 chopped garlic cloves, 2 tablespoons of flour, 1 cup of milk, 2 cans of tuna, that is 240 grams of tuna, drained tuna, half a cup of frozen peas or green peas, half a cup of corn, grated cheese, and that's optional. And I have taken salt and pepper for seasoning and of course chili flakes to add some heat. For the pastry dough, get 3 cups of flour, that is 300 grams roughly. Then 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 2 large eggs, 1 egg has to be taken for egg wash, 120 grams of butter. It's better if you can keep this in the freezer before making the dough. Then ice cold water, that is 75 milligrams roughly. Then 1 teaspoon of baking powder. So let's get started.
So as the first step, we need to sift flour into a mixing bowl. So get 300 grams of flour and then mix it properly into a mixing bowl. At this point, you also need to add 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Now sift it properly into the mixing bowl. So after done with sifting, you need to add butter lightly at a time, little by little into the mixture. Make sure that you keep it in the freezer at least 30 minutes before you making the dough, as I've said earlier. Then it's very easy to mix it with the flour and then break it down into the flour. Also, make sure that you wash your hands properly or use hand gloves, because you have to use your hands to mix it. Now mix it very lightly so it comes to a breadcrumbs consistency. Continue the rest with 120 grams of butter. Also, if your butter is less salty, then add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Make sure that there aren't any lumps or butter in the mixture. You need to lightly mix it. So, as the next step, we need to first beat the egg. And then add some ice water into the beaten egg. If you use smaller eggs, it's better to take 2 small eggs and mix it with ice water. After mixing it, we need to add the egg mixture little at a time into the butter flour mixture and then mix everything together. Also, if your mixture is over, egg mixture is over, then you can even use some cold water to mix the rest of the dough. And also, this dough has to be a stiff dough, so don't add so much of water. Make sure that you know that properly. And also, don't press the dough too much using your weight. Just use your fingers to mix it very lightly.
Now I have combined everything and made the pastry dough. Now I am going to take it out from the bowl and knead it for a couple of minutes. first we need to roll out the dough and fold it once, and then fold it again and roll it once more. Likewise, you need to continue for a couple of minutes. Roughly this will take around 2 to 3 minutes. And then once you are done with rolling out, then you can cover this using a kitchen towel or a cling film and keep it in the fridge for 30 minutes. But make sure that you don't keep it in the freezer. Just 30 minutes in the fridge would work. Meanwhile, let's make the filling. First, heat the pan with 2 tablespoons of butter, and then add 3 chopped garlic cloves into the pan. And then I've also add 1 chopped small onion. Now you need to saute until fragrant for a couple of seconds. This smells so good. Now it's the time to add 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. Then stir around just for a couple of minutes until it's cooked. Now add 1 cup of milk, half at a time, and then give it a good mix. After a couple of seconds, add other half of milk and then stir until it becomes kind of creamy. If you want, you can add heavy cream here, but I have used fresh milk. Now it has become a little thicker, as you can see. Now let's add the rest of the ingredients. Add 240 grams of drained tuna, and then half a cup of corn, half a cup of frozen peas, and some grated cheese, but that's optional. Give it a slight mix. Then give it a good seasoning with black pepper, pinch of salt, and of course some chili flakes. But if you don't like that to be so spicy, then only add salt and pepper. Now give it a gentle mix until everything is well combined, but don't crush your tunas. Now I think this filling is gonna be so good. Now let's keep it until it's completely cool and work with our pastry. Now I have taken the pastry dough from the fridge after 30 minutes. As you can see, it's easy to work with the dough after it was rested for nearly 30 minutes. Now I'm going to get 1/2 from the dough and keep the other half covered from a cling film and to be rested for another couple of minutes. And then I'm going to work with the first half of the dough. Now get the roller and then thin the pastry dough, because I need same size circles from the pastry dough. So just for that we need to make it more thinner. Look how I am doing it now, and then make the pastry dough very thin. And then at this point we need to have a pastry cutter, and then cut same size circle out of the pastry dough. I have used a cookie tin lid as my pastry cutter because I need to have more filling inside the pasty, so it has to be quite big. But it's your choice, you can get a jar lid or a plate or anything you prefer, and then have same size circles from the pastry dough, and then you need to continue it for the rest of the dough also. As you can see, we can easily make 6 circles from the pastry dough. Now I'm going to make the pasties. First, we need to get the roller and make it more thinner. and then get a spoon size from the filling and then keep it in the middle of the circle. As you can see, I have taken a bigger circle because then I can have more fillings inside. And now you have to brush the edges with some water. Now bring two opposite sides up to pinch together over the filling. This has to be sealed properly using your fingers, and then make the design using your fingers. As you can see, it's very easy. You can just see how I'm doing it now. This has to be looks like a back of a dinosaur, and you need to repeat the same for the rest of the circles. And meantime, preheat the oven to 200 degrees Celsius, that is 400 degree Fahrenheit, and I'm going to continue the same. Pasties on a baking tray with a parchment paper and brush with egg wash. We need to bake at 200 degrees Celsius for the first 15 minutes and then reduce the temperature to 175 Celsius for further 25 to 30 minutes. After that, we need to pick a hole using a toothpick so it will not burst open in the oven. You can see I'm doing it now. And after that, we need to bake our pasties. Now it's the tea time, so we have our delicious tuna Cornish pasties ready to be served with hot ginger tea.
So now you can make these delicious tuna Cornish pasties easily with following my instructions. And it took roughly 30 minutes for me to prepare the pasties and the filling, and 40 to 45 minutes in the oven. So you can put it in an airtight container and keep it in the fridge for like 5 days and frozen up for 2 months. So I hope you like the video. Please do subscribe to get regular updates and like and share with your friends. So thank you for watching. See you soon.